in this verse, our Maitreya is telling that one important thing. In the previous chapter, Vidura was glorifying Maitreya. Vidura was like telling that, I am very fortunate to have a guru like you. All my doubts are cleared and I would like to hear more and more Krishna Katha in relation to all these following queries, etc. etc. And if you answer all these queries, you will actually, what is that? You are known as Maitreya. You are the son of Mitra. And you actually make it true, your name. Your name indicates that you are friend of everyone. But by speaking about these topics of Lord Krishna, you make your name real and true. Like that, Vidura glorified Maitreya. But here in this chapter, Maitreya is glorifying Vidura. He says that Yel Lokapalo Bhagavat Pradhana. You are one of the Lokapalas. Here is indicating Vidura to be the Yamaraj. As Yamaraj, you are one of the Lokapalas. Even being born in the family of Kshatriyas, you are also one of the Lokapalas. He is the son of Vyasadeva through the maidservant of Ambika. So from the is in that Kshatriya lineage, he is the being chief minister in that sense. And you have made Bhagavan to be the goal of your life. Bhagavat Pradhana. Though there is Brahman, Paramatma and Bhagavan, but you have accepted Bhagavan to be your life and goal. So, Satsevaniyo Bhatapuru Vamsho. And because of you being born in the family of Purus, you being accepting Bhagavan to be your object of worship, you made Puruvamsha to be the most worshipable, the most worthy of respect. Sat Sevaniyo. Sat Vamsha and Sevaniya Vamsha, you made it like that, Puruvamsha. Babuvita Jiha Kirti Malam. And by your inquiries, all these inquiries, you are actually making Pade Pade at every step the Krishna Katha to be wonderful garland, wonderful fragrant garland. Nutanasya Abhikshanam. Nutanasya Abhikshanam. It appears to be ever new, ever fresh by your inquiries. This is your greatness. And in fact, you mentioned that you are fortunate to have my association. But I would say that I have become fortunate by your association. You, my dear Amaraj, have appeared in this world as Vidura in order to deliver me. So this is how Maitreya is acknowledging the great position of Vidura. From that point of view, he is not feeling that, okay, you accepted me as guru, so now I am guru, I'll sit on the ICT, you sit in front of me and I'll teach you, not like that. Instead, he's saying that you have appeared and you have come in the form of Vidura just to deliver me. You are a wonderful devotee of the Supreme Lord. So like that, he in fact, he is actually glorifying, he is acknowledging the great position and great devotional qualities of Vidura. So when two devotees meet, this should be the kind of interaction between them. When this kind of interaction is there, there will be no place for envy. There will be no place for hatred. There will be no place for competition. There will be no place for expecting respect from others, etc., etc. This is what Mahaprabhu wanted us to learn. What is the third verse of Chaitanya Shastakam? Can anyone say tell? Yeah. Loudly. So that they will hear. Like that. Amanina Manadena. That is only possible as long as we continue to respect others. If we are respecting respect, then we will be not able to follow this principle. So that we can see between Maitreya and Vidura. None of them are proud of their position. They are actually very humble and they're eager to serve each other. So in that way. Now, this is another important verse of Srimad Bhagavatam. This is there in your exam also. Soham runam chulla sukaya dukkam mahat gatanam viramaya tasya pravartaye bhagavatam puranam yadaha sakshat bhagavan rishibhya.
Let me now, speaking on the Bhagavad Purana, which was directly spoken to the great sages by the personality of Godhead for the benefit of those who are entangled in extreme miseries for the sake of very little pleasure.
So this verse states that Soham runam chulla sukaya dukkam mahad. For the sake of chulla sukha, the people runam, the people of this world going through mahad dukkam. So this is what the query asked by Vidura at the beginning of the fifth chapter when he approached Maitreya. Sukaya karmani karoti loko nate sukam vana yad viparamamba. Vindeta bhuya tateva dukkam yadatra yuktam bhagavan vadena. This was the one of the beginning slokas of the fifth chapter. So there he asked that, so my dear Lord, I observed in this world that people perform various act, undertake so many activities in order to get happiness and in order to mitigate their miseries. They are the two anticipated things they are expecting. So, but they are not able to get one of the two. They are neither getting happiness nor mitigating their misery. Instead, they are getting more misery. Then the next thing would be, they should stop performing any activity, because activity is giving more misery instead of mitigating the previous misery and giving happiness. But instead, they are thinking that if by performing this activity, I'm only getting more misery, let me start another activity. Hopefully, I will remove all my past miseries and get more happiness, get happiness, etc. But that is not possible. They are continuously put in continual misery. So what is the solution for this? He only asks what is the reason there, but indirectly indicates that what is the solution for this. So now Maitreya is going to tell the solution. So what is that? Mahatgatanam viramaya tasya. In order to change their destiny, matlab, by doing what their destiny can be changed. So that is described in Srimad Bhagavatam. That Bhagavatam now I will speak. Pravartaye Bhagavatam Puranam. So in order to viramaya tasya pravartaye, in order to transform their destiny, in order to bring happiness in their lives, I will speak Srimad Bhagavatam. And somebody may question, hey, what is this Bhagavatam? You are speaking something new thing. He said that, Yadaha Sakshat Bhagavan Rishibhya. The personality of Godhead directly spoke this Bhagavatam to the four Rishis, the four Kumaras. He spoke this Bhagavatam to four Rishis, and that Bhagavatam, I will recite to you, which will be answer to all your questions, which you asked in the previous chapter, and which will also be the answer to your first question, which you asked when you approached me. So in that way, Maitreya starts the conversation. So I would like to speak that Bhagavatam, which was spoken by Bhagavan to the Rishis. Now, who is that Bhagavan who spoke this Bhagavatam? Who are those Rishis who heard this Bhagavatam? Where the conversation took place, etc., etc., is the subject matter of the next 6-7 verses. That we will discuss for today.
Okay, this is after the meeting of Maitreya Muni with Uddhava,
right? Ah, yes.
So Uddhava has met Maitreya Muni as Krishna has already passed away, and then
Krishna already disappeared.
And Maitreya is now meeting Mudra. So he's in that meeting, Krishna spoke about this conversation between him and the Kumaras.
Right. So is Prabhuji asking that previously Maitreya along with Uddhava met Lord Krishna in Prabhas. So there did Lord Krishna spoke about this Bhagavatam to Maitreya during that time? Like that Prabhuji is asking. So how did Maitreya came to know about that Bhagavatam which was discussed by Bhagavan with the Rishis? We'll come to know in the next 6-7 verses. That is the topic in the next 6-7 verses. So आसीनमौर्यं भगवन्तमाद्यं संकर्षणं देवमकुण्ठसत्त्वं विविस्तितत्त्वमतः परस्य कुमारमुख्या मुनयोन्वपृच्छ.
Sometimes ago, being inquisitive to know, Sanat Kumara, the chief of the boy saints, accompanied by other great sages, inquired exactly like you about the truth regarding Vasudeva, the Supreme, from Lord Sankarsana, who is seated at the bottom of the universe.
Yeah. So in the previous verse mentioned about two people, two personalities. Who are they? Yadaha Sakshat Bhagavan Rishibhya. There was one Bhagavan, there was one Rishi. Rishi means, Rishibhya means Rishis, plural. So who are the Rishis and who is the Bhagavan? this is clarified in the present verse. So who is the rishi? Asinamuryam bhagavanta madhya sankarshanam devamakunta sattvam. Who is that bhagavan? Sankarshana. Lord Sankarshana. Who is that Sankarshana? Asinamuryam. Uryam means the location of the urus, the thighs. If you remember the universal form that has been described in the second canto, first chapter, and second canto, fifth chapter, not six. So in these two chapters, the 14 planetary systems were identified with different body limbs of the Supreme Lord. Yeah. The abdomen portion, the upper portion of the thighs is like the bhuloka. Just below that bhuloka, atala, vitala, sutala, talatala, mahatala, etc. It is here mentioned the asina uryam. Just below the urus, just below the thighs, thoda neche, uska neche, he is situated. Who? Lord Sankarshana is situated there. Bhagavanta Madhya is called Adi. Bhagavanta, from the very beginning, he is situated there. He is the original personality of Godhead. Devam Akunta Sattvam. Who is he? He is Sankarshana. And is imbued with akunta sattvam, pure goodness, without any ignorance in him. Kunta means deformities or ignorance, whatever it is. Akunta, without any akunta, and is pure sattva, without any contamination of mode of passion and mode of ignorance. From that way, you can say he is pure goodness personified. Yeah. Vivistas tattvam ata parasya. Kumara Mukhya Munayona Prucha. Kumara Mukhya. The four Kumaras. Who are the rishis? Rishis are the four Kumaras. And these four Munis, Anva Prucha, they spoke to Lord Sankarshana. For what purpose they spoke to Lord Sankarshana? Vivitva was Tattvam Ata Parasya. Parasya means the Supreme Personality of God, who is situated in the Paravyuma, in the spiritual world. In order to understand the characteristics of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, they have approached Lord Sankarshana and asked questions unto him. Just the way you ask questions, they also ask questions to Maitreya, with a desire to understand about the nature and the personality of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. So this was the topic of the conversation and the people involved in the conversation. Then what happened? Swameva Dishnam Bahumanayantam Yadva Sudeva Aditam Yadva Sudeva Abidam Amananti Pratyak Dhritaksha Ambuja Kosha Mishat Unmilayantam Vibuddodayaya.
At that time, Sankarshana was meditating upon his Supreme Lord, whom the learned esteem as Lord Vasudeva. But for the sake of the advancement of the great learned sages, he slightly opened his lotus-like eyes and began to speak.
So when Kumaras approached Lord Sankarshana, what was he doing? What was the activity performed by Lord Sankarshana? Swam eva dishnam bahumana yantam Yad Vasudevabhi Idam Amananti. So basically, he was contemplating, or he was doing smaranam. He was doing smaranam of the pastimes of Lord Vasudeva. Because when Lord Shesha, he appeared as the son of Kadru and Kashyapa. So seeing the conflicts between the sons of stepmothers, the snakes and Garuda and many others, they are the Daityas and Dana, Daityas and Devatas, they are all fighting. Because these are all sons of Kashyapa only. Kashyapa had many wives and all the sons were fighting with each other. So, but Shesha, who was the first son of Kadru, he was not happy with all this fighting among the brothers. So he went to forest and performed austerities unto Lord Brahma. Lord Brahma appeared and he asked, "My dear son, what do you want?" He said that, "Let me have the friendly nature towards all my brothers." Lord Brahma said, "Okay, Tatasu. Then, do you want anything more?" Then Shesha told that, "I want to serve the Supreme Lord. I want to serve in some way or other." Then Brahma told that, "My dear son, please go down to Bhumandala and carry the entire weight of Bhumandala." Then he said, "Yes, yes, my dear Lord. I'll go down and do the needful. Plus, tell me, how long I should do this service. He expected, he wanted some time limit. Then Lord Brahma told that, you go down and while carrying the Bhumandala, you meditate upon the Supreme Lord's wonderful qualities and activities. When you come to the end, then stop your service. So Tapse, this pastime happened during Chakshusha Manvantara. After the pralaya that took place during Chakshusha Manvantara, after the appearance of Lord Matsya. So since then he was carrying the weight of the entire Bhumandala and doing smaranam of Lord's pastimes. So that even when Kumaras came also, he was doing the same thing. But when we heard the request of Kumaras, Bahumana Yantam, being pleased and giving the great respect to four Kumaras, Pratyek Dhrita Aksha Ambuja Kosham Ishad, Unmila Yantam, he slightly opened, or he gradually opened his lotus-like eyes with an intention to respond to the queries of four Kumaras. Because four Kumaras have come all the way from Janaloka up to Patala Loka or below Patala Loka. Lord Shesha is situated below Patala Loka, in fact. So they came all the way below here. So being pleased with the hard work of four Kumaras, he opened his eyes in order to respond.
Hare Krishna, Prabhuji.
Yes, Mataji.
Prabhuji, before Chakshusha Manvantara, else was holding for Bhumandala.
That time also Shesha was holding, but that time Shesha was the son of somebody else. And during Chakshusha Manvantara, he was again born as the son of Kashyapa and Kadru.
Okay, so all the time he is only holding.
Yeah, you only hold. If somebody is interested, they can go.
No. What I meant is you mentioned that in Chakshusha Manvantara, Brahma told that you go and do this service. So I was thinking that before that, then who was doing like?
No, not like that. I mentioned in relation to Kashyapa and Kadru. Of course, these things we'll get to discuss in the sixth canto. Sixth canto talks about all these things. So basically, there will be Shesha is holding always, but during that pralaya, Shesha gave service. And later on, he was born again as the son of Kashyapa and Kadru. Before that, he might have been the son of somebody else. If no one is there, the Supreme Lord himself will hold Bhumandala upon his head as Shesha.
Okay.
He is there as a substitute whenever there is no one. He will do the needful. Otherwise, currently that this personality is there, he is doing. So, in that way. So, this past time happened in Chakshusha Manvantara. That's why I mentioned about the Chakshusha Manvantara.
Okay, Prabhuji. Thank you.
So, Mahabharata talks about this in great detail. Adiparva of Mahabharata. So, now, the details about Kumaras. Who are the Kumaras? So, why they came to Lord Sankarsana, etc. That is being mentioned now.
The sages came from the highest planets down to the lower region through the water of the Ganges, and therefore the hair on their heads was wet. The hair on their head was wet. They touched the lotus feet of the Lord, which are worshipped with various paraphernalia by the daughters of the serpent king when they desire good husbands.
So, if you remember, if you have heard from devotees about the Vamandev pastime, so Vamana appeared in the sacrificial arena, Bali Maharaj requested for 3 paise of land, when Bali Maharaj sanctioned, he kind of expanded. With 1 foot, he occupied the entire Bhumandala. With the 2 foot, he occupied Bhuvarloka, Sargaloka, Maharloka, Janaloka, Tapaloka, everything. They can see. So, the toenail of his feet, it created a crack on the universal shell. Then the Karna Ocean entered into our universe. First it came to Satyaloka, then Janaloka, Tapaloka, Maharloka, and Sargaloka, Bhuvarloka, Bhuloka, etc. Then because of Bhagirath Maharaj, the same Ganga went all the way up to Patal Loka in order to deliver their ancestors, the 60,000 sons of Sagar Maharaj. So Mother Ganga is there all over the universe. So following the path of Ganga, from Janaloka, the four Kumaras reside in Janaloka, just below Brahmaloka. Following the path of Ganga, they came down all the way up to Patala Loka. Then after crossing Patala Loka, they come to the position of Lord Sankarsana, where he is situated below Patala Loka, holding the entire Bhumandala upon his head. So since they came along with Ganga, their jata or their whole body, their clothes, everything is wet. They are wet basically. Upaspruchantas. And they came to the lotus feet of Lord Sankarsana. And when they came, what they observed here? Padmam. No. Padanam Padmam is lotus feet. Charanopadanam Padmam. Yadarchanti Ahiraja Kanya. Ahiraja Kanya means, Ahi means snakes. The snakes are living in the lower planets. Mahatala and Padala, they are the two lower planets which are fully occupied by the snakes. Hare Krishna, all of you can mute when you are not speaking. Disturbance is there in the voice. So, Ahiraja Kanya, the girls of the daughters of the snakes, saw Prema with love and affection. Nana Balibir, offering so many gifts, so many worshipful objects. Vararta, with a desire to get suitable husband, they are actually worshipping Lord Sankarsana. This is what is being observed by four Kumaras when they came down. The Nagakanyas were worshipping Lord Sankarsana by offering so many gifts with a desire to get suitable husbands. So in that way. Mohor Grunanto Vachasanuraga Skalat Padanya Sakritani Tagna Kirita Sahasramani Praveka Pradyotito Dhamapanas Sahasram.
The four Kumaras, headed by Sanat Kumara, who all knew the transcendental pastimes of the Lord, glorified the Lord in rhythmic accents with selected words full of affection and love. At that time, Lord Sankarsana, with his thousands of raised hoods, began to radiate an effulgence from the glowing stones on his head.
So, Skalat Padanyasa Kritani Tajna. Vachasanu Raga. So basically says that during that time, when Nagakanyas were worshipping, the four Kumaras came and with very humility, very humbleness, with what do you say? Skalat Padanyasa, with trembling words, they presented their request to Lord Sankarsana. And how the Lord Sankarsana is visible? Kirita Sahasra Mani Praveka Pradyoti Toddama Fana Sahasram. He had thousands of hoods, among which one hood is holding the entire Bhumandala. And upon every hood, there is Kirita, there is Mukut. And every Mukut has one Mani Praveka, one of the best of jewels, with which his thousand Mukuts are shining brightly. And to that Lord, they made their request to hear about Supreme Personality of Godhead. Then Lord Sankarsana began to reply. Proktam kalaita bhagavatamena nivritti dharma biratayatena sanat kumaraya sachaha parshta sankhyayanaya angadrutavrataya.
Lord Sankarsana spoke the purport of Srimad Bhagavatam to the great sage Sanat Kumara, already taken the vow of renunciation. Sanat Kumara also, in his turn, when inquired by Sankhyayan Muni, explained Srimad Bhagavatam as he had heard it from Sankarsana.
So, proktam kalaitad bhagavattamena. Here, this bhagavattamena indicates Lord Sankarsana. Lord Sankarsana, who is also Bhagavan, who is always meditating upon Bhagavan, the best of Bhagavatas. So he spoke nivritti dharmena abhirataya tena. He spoke about bhakti, which is nivritti dharma. Bhakti is called as nivritti dharma. So he spoke about devotional service unto Lord, or in one sense he spoke about the process which will take one back to Godhead, unto the four Kumaras. Abhirataya tena, since they are already interested in understanding the subject matter. And then eventually, later in due course of time, Sanat Kumaraya Sachaha Prishta Sankhyaya Nanga Dhritavrataya. A self-determined sage known as Sankhyayana, when he approached four Kumaras about the understanding the same subject matter, Sanat Kumara spoke to him. eventually later on Sanat Kumara repeated the same Bhagavatam which he heard from Lord Sankarsana to Sankhyayana Rishi. He is another sage about whom we generally don't hear so much, but he is one sage who was there in the past. So now next verse talks about Sankhyayana Rishi talking the same Bhagavatam to Parashara. Sankhyayana Paramahamsa Mukyo Vivakshamano Bhagavad Vibhuti Jagadasosmad Gurave Nivitya Gugum Asmad Gurave Anvitaya Parasharasha Parasha Parashariyata Brahaspatescha.
The great sage Sankhyayana was the chief amongst the transcendentalists, and when he was describing the glories of the Lord in terms of Srimad Bhagavatam, it so happened that my spiritual master Parashara and Brahaspati both heard him.
So eventually later on, Sankhyayana Rishi, Paramahamsa Mukhya, the best of Paramahamsas, Vivakshamano, with a desire to speak the same Bhagavatam which he had heard from four Kumaras to the devotees in general, the glories of the Lord, he spoke to my Guru, Asmad Guru. He said that he spoke to our Guru, like kind of giving respect to his Guru. Parashara Ayata. He spoke unto Parashara Muni and also he spoke to Brahaspati. So Sankhyayana Muni spoke the same Bhagavatam both to Parashara Muni and Brahaspati. So these two have heard from Sankhyayana Rishi. Uddhava is not Brahaspati's son. Brahaspati is Deva Guru. Brahaspati is the preceptor of the Devatas, is the Guru of the Devatas. Shukracharya is the Guru of Danavas and Brahaspati is the Guru of Devatas. So this is the last verse for today's discussion. We will stop with this. Provachamayam sadayalu rukto muni pulasena purana madhyam soham tavaitat katayami vasta shraddha lave nitya manurataya.
The great sage Parashara, as aforementioned, being so advised by the great sage Pulastya, spoke unto me the foremost of the Puranas, Bhagavatam. I shall also describe this before you, my dear son, in terms of my hearing, because you are always my faithful follower.
So this is the qualification for hearing. Shraddha lave, one should be faithful. Anurataya, one should be dedicated to serve the Guru. So dedicated to follow the Guru. So they are qualified to hear. So that means dedicated to follow the instructions of Guru, even though I may not be a so-called, I may not be a Guru, but somehow or other I have given this responsibility. So all of you are requested to complete your pending assignments. Then I will be entitled to speak. I will be entitled to continue Bhakti Vaibhav. So I gave 2 weeks all days for all of you to complete pending assignments. And I didn't, till date I did not receive the completion of assignments from many devotees. So this is my humble request to all of you. See, kindly do the needful. At least fulfill the minimum expectations from the student for Bhakti Vaibhav. So
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Prabhuji, whether Sankhyayana Muni is also known as Pulatsya Muni?
No. Let me speak.
Laughing so much. Why you laughing so much?
Because in front of me one student is there. He is laughing, so I am laughing. That's why. Sorry. So don't take it any personal, but this is just because the context is like that. I mentioned about it. Nothing, anything about personal. So please. It is only a request, not an order.
Sankhyayana Muni, is it the same as Pulatsya Muni? Because here it says the 8th shloka that the great sage Sankhyayana was the chief amongst the transcendentalists, and Then what next loka is saying, the great sage Parasar, as aforementioned, being so advised by the great sage Pulatsya. Means,
wait, let me explain. I did not start the explanation of the verse. Wait. I'll tell you one story. This is the story, a take-home story for you today. So this verse says that Provacha Mayam Sa Dayalu Rukto, that Dayalu personality, who is he? Asmat Guru, Parashara. He spoke to me, that Bhagavatam. Munir Pulasya Purana Madhyam Soham Tavaitat Katayami Vasta. So why Pulasya Nam comes here is that if you have heard Ramayan, if you have read Ramayan, you can make, I mean, you can understand this, what is happening here in the background. So in the Ramayan, there is a discussion about the fight between Vasishta and Vishwamitra. So Vishwamitra one day went on hunting. He felt hungry and thirsty. He approached the ashram of Vasishta. Vasishta fed Vishwamitra and all his entourage, army, etc. very nicely. And Vishwamitra was surprised. Hey, you are a mendicant. You are a sannyasi living with a sadhu. Not sannyasi. It's gross, I think. It's gross only. You are living in Vanaprastha. Not Vanaprastha only. You are living in the forest. And how could you feed all these people like this? Then he said that I have a Nandini cow with me. That cow can provide me everything that I need. So, but Vishwamitra being a king, he thought that everything best in this world should be with me because I am the king of everything. So he requested Vasishta, and please give me the cow. But Vasishta humbly pleaded that, see, my dear king, you have everything with you. I only have the cow. I need to perform Agnihota sacrifice every day. And this cow will give me everything that I need for this Agnya. If you take that cow, how can I do that? Then he said that I am king, I can do anything. Then he said that no problem, whatever you want to do it. Then he told his army to drag the cow. As the cow is being dragged, the cow requests Vasishta, my dear master, how can you leave me? Then Vasishta said that what can I do? I am a old man and I can't do much. Then the cow said that you order me, I will do everything, whatever you need. Then Vasishta orders cow, you do the needful to stay with me. The cow produces all the variety of army who fought with the army of Vishwamitra and defeated them. Then Vishwamitra understood that the Kshatriya energy, the Kshatriya physical strength is nowhere in comparison to the mystic strength of a Brahmana. This Brahmana has all the mystic weapons. So he, Vishwamitra, goes and performs tapasya. He acquires all the mystic weapons to fight with Vishwamitra. He comes and tries to fight with Vishwamitra. Fight with Vasishta. And Vasishta, using his Brahmadanda, in the movies, if you see that hand kept, that hand rest, that he called Brahmadanda. So with that, he produces, he counteracts all the weapons released by Vishwamitra. Then he understood that, I mean, like that, the fight was going between both Vishwamitra and Vasishta. And during that fight, at one point of time, to destroy Vasishta and all his entourage, he created a fiery demon, a fiery Rakshasa. That fiery Rakshasa destroys the entire Agnya, the arena of the sacrificial arena of Vasishta, and he destroyed the, all the disciples of Vasishta. That demon even kills the 100 sons of Vasishta. Vasishta had 100 sons. The eldest was Shakti. He was killed by this fiery demon. So Mataji, you mute. Kindly mute. So Shakti was died. That time Vasishta was feeling very sad. Because he had 100 sons died, all his disciples died, everything is destroyed. So I lost my life. Karke, I mean, he was kind of traveling to forest to forest, forest to forest. So he was feeling very bad that all my sons are died. So who will take care of me? Who will perform Shraddha for me, etc. Like that he was thinking and going. So but his daughter-in-law knew that she already became pregnant. Shakti's wife was already pregnant and she was following her father-in-law. Eventually, when she met and she told that, my dear father, they used to call the father-in-law also father in the previous Vedic culture. If you don't worry, your son is dead, but your grandson is there in my womb. So you are not orphan. I mean, what do you say? You don't feel that you don't have anyone in your dynasty. Your dynasty is still intact. Then Vasishta comes home and takes care of his daughter-in-law and And when the child is born, he names him as Parashara and he teaches him everything, etc., etc. Eventually, when Parashara was grown up, he heard that a Rakshasa was Vishwamitra, and by now Vishwamitra became Vishwamitra by all the pastimes also. So a Rakshasa actually killed my father and all my uncles, everyone, they were killed by this fiery Rakshasa. So now Parashara, that Parashara becomes very angry with this Rakshasas. So he performs a yajna with an intention to uproot all the Rakshasas, with an intention to kill all the Rakshasas, destroy all the Rakshasas. As he was doing that, one by one all the Rakshasas were falling into yajna and they were burnt. So when Vasishta came to know about this, so Vasishta comes to his grandson Parashara and tells him, my dear grandson, don't do this. One Rakshasa might have killed your father and uncles. So you already killed him. You have done sufficiently. No, stop it. Stop this yajna immediately. Then Parashara, out of respect for his grandfather, stopped that yajna. So when Pulasa hears all this thing, what all happened? Because all the Rakshasas were the grandsons of Pulasya. Pulasya's grandsons, his dynasty is all Rakshasas. So he becomes very happy, he comes to Parashara and he actually gives a blessing to Parashara. He tells that, may you become the speaker of all the Puranas. So because hearing the words of grandfather, Parashara stopped the performance of yajna wherein all the Rakshasas are supposed to enter. So his dynasty is saved. So Pulasya becomes very much happy with the conduct of Parashara and he blesses him to become the speaker of the Puranas. And that Parashara later on spoke Vishnu Purana to Maitreya and Vyasadev. Vyasa was the son of Parashara. Both Maitreya and Vyasa were the students of Parashara. And Parashara spoke the entire Vishnu Purana to Maitreya. That was the Bhagavatam which is being discussed in these previous verses. That Bhagavatam which was spoken by Lord Sankarsana to four Kumaras, Sanat Kumara spoke to Sankhyana, Sankhyana spoke to Bruhaspati and Parashara, and that Parashara with the blessings of Pulasya became expert at speaking, at narrating Puranas. And he narrated Bhagavatam to Maitreya and Vyasa. That Bhagavatam is known as Vishnu Purana today. So that Bhagavatam, I'll speak to you now. So this is the story behind it. Hare Krishna, thank you very much. It is already 8:45. All of you might be feeling very hungry. Sorry for taking more time from all of you. So
Hare Krishna, Prabhuji.
Yes, Mataji.
One doubt, Prabhuji. Bhrigu Muni is different?
Yeah, Bhrigu is different. And Pulasya is different. Both of them are brothers. They were all born to Brahma. We will discuss about them in the 12th chapter.
Okay, Hare Krishna. Thank you, Prabhuji.
Hare Krishna, Prabhuji. Thank you for such a nice explanation, detail. But Vishnu Purana and Bhagavatam is same, Prabhuji.
Both are talking about bhakti only, both are talking about dashavataras, both are talking about same pastimes. The only difference in the Bhagavatam is Lord Krishna's pastimes are spoken over 120 chapters, 90 plus 30 in the 11th canto. So in the Vishnu Purana, it might be a little less. That is the only difference.
Okay, thank you, Prabhuji.
Bhagavatam is specifically dedicated to Lord Krishna avatara and Vishnu Purana dedicated to all the avatars. So all the avatars, you can hear about them more details in the Vishnu Purana. So in Bhagavatam, Lord Krishna given more importance. That is the only difference. Otherwise, philosophy and all is the same.
Okay, so Parashara spoke the Vishnu Purana to...
Yes.
Okay. Okay, thank you, Prabhuji.
Hare Krishna, thank you very much. Grantara Srimad Bhagavatam ki jai. అనంతకోటి వైష్ణవ భక్త బృంది కి జై. శ్రీల ప్రభుపాదికి.